Hello everyone, today's video is about a very important condition related to triglyceride metabolism, and that is fatty liver. At the end of this video, you should be able to explain various causes of fatty liver and the role of lipotropic factors in prevention of this condition. Normal healthy liver is not a storage organ of fat. Fatty acid synthesis and lipogenesis occurs in the liver, but this triacylglycerol are not stored in the liver, and normally less than 5% of lipid is stored in the liver, and that is also phospholipids. And in the normal liver, Kupffer cell contains lipid in the form of small droplets, but in fatty liver, that droplet of triacylglycerol occupies entire cytoplasm of hepatic cells. So whenever there is accumulation of fat in hepatocytes, it is called as fatty liver. And when that fat accumulation is associated with the inflammatory changes, it leads to scar formation in the hepatocytes. So that formation of scarring leads to fibrosis, and the condition is called liver fibrosis. And when this liver fibrosis becomes extensive in the chronic condition, entire hepatocytes become scarred, and it leads to irreversible condition, that is liver cirrhosis. So these are the various stages of liver damage. The fatty liver and in some condition liver fibrosis can be reversible if proper measures are taken. But once the liver cirrhosis is developed, then it cannot be reversed. What is fatty liver? It is the deposition of excess triglyceride in the hepatocytes. Fatty acid synthesis occurs in the liver in well-fed condition, and these fatty acids are packaged in the form of triacylglycerol, that is lipogenesis also occurs in liver. This triacylglycerol can also be derived from chylomicron remnant. In fasting and starvation and in condition of diabetes mellitus, fatty acids are derived from lipolysis, that is the breakdown of triacylglycerol in fatty acid and glycerol. And these fatty acids are transported to the liver. In fasting and starvation, liver can utilize fatty acid for energy. Then this triacylglycerol in the liver, as they are not stored, they are secreted in the form of VLDL. And through this VLDL, which is a lipoprotein, they are transported to the peripheral tissues like adipose tissues and muscle. In the adipose tissue, triacylglycerol present in the VLDL is broken down into fatty acids and glycerol by the action of enzyme lipoprotein lipase. Fatty acids are taken up by the adipose tissue for storage and for energy purpose in the muscle. When fatty liver occurs, when there is increased synthesis of fatty acids, it is exceeded than its utilization and excretion. So if synthesis is more, but it is not being utilized by the organ and it is not being excreted through the organ, then it leads to accumulation of triacylglycerol in the liver. So when does this happen? Whenever there is increased lipolysis, it will lead to increased breakdown of triacylglycerol, more number of fatty acid will be transported to the liver, but that increased fatty acid cannot be oxidized through TCA cycle by the liver and it cannot be utilized. So ultimately it will result in the accumulation of this fatty acid in the form of triacylglycerol. Or the formed triacylglycerol cannot be excreted through the VLDL and they cannot be transported to peripheral tissue. In that condition, the normal liver, there is excess deposition of triacylglycerol in the hepatocytes and it leads to fatty liver. So which means that there are important causes of fatty liver. Whenever there is increased synthesis of triacylglycerol or fatty acid more than its utilization and excretion, it leads to fatty liver. Fatty liver is of two types. If it is caused due to chronic alcohol intake, it is called as alcoholic fatty liver. And if there is no alcohol intake, so fatty liver due to any condition other than alcohol, it is called as non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. The various Conditions which are associated with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease are morbid obesity, type 2 diabetes mellitus, insulin resistance, hyperlipidemia, and hypertension. So non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is related with the metabolic syndrome. And the spectrum of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is from less severe to more severe condition. And the first is hepatic steatosis, that is fatty liver, where triglyceride is accumulated in the hepatocytes. If the triacylglycerol accumulated is associated with the inflammation, it is called as NASH, that is non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. And third is more severe condition, that is liver cirrhosis, when fat accumulation along with the inflammation is associated with extensive fibrosis, it is liver cirrhosis. So this is the spectrum of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. What are the various causes of fatty liver? The first, when there is increased synthesis of triglyceride. Second, if there is reduced utilization of fats by the liver. And third, if there is reduced removal of fats from the liver due to impaired lipoprotein synthesis. Let's first see the causes of increased synthesis of triglycerides. The first cause is when high fat diet is consumed, it directly elevates triglyceride level. Even if the excess carbohydrates are consumed, it also favors fatty acid synthesis and lipogenesis. Hence, it is associated with the obesity. In conditions of diabetes mellitus and starvation, there is increased lipolysis, triacylglycerol are broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. So there is more mobilization of fatty acids from adipose tissue to the liver. So number of fatty acids transported to the liver is more than its capacity to utilize them. So the increased level of fatty acid then leads to increased synthesis of triglyceride. A liver is not able to utilize the fatty acids which are there in the liver, and the triacylglycerol is not able to removed from the liver. So increased fatty acids reaching to the liver exceeds the capacity of liver to utilize them or to excrete them, and that's why triacylglycerol are deposited in the hepatocytes and it leads to fatty liver. The second cause of fatty liver is reduced utilization of fats by the liver, and it occurs in chronic alcoholism. Alcoholism causes fatty liver by two important mechanisms. First, by inhibiting fatty acid oxidation, and second, by promoting lipogenesis. How alcohol is metabolized in the body? Alcohol is converted into acetaldehyde, and then acetaldehyde is converted into acetic acid. During this metabolism, there is increased NADH production, and it leads to increased NADH to NAD positive ratio. And as there is more NADH, malate is not be able to convert it into oxaloacetate, because for conversion of malate to oxaloacetate, NAD is required, and in alcohol metabolism, there is decreased NAD and increased NADH, and that's why there is decreased oxaloacetate. Oxaloacetate is the intermediate of Krebs cycle, and it is required for acetyl-CoA to be oxidized in the Krebs cycle. And if there is decreased oxaloacetate, acetyl-CoA cannot be oxidized in the TCA cycle, that is Krebs cycle. And that's why the fatty acid oxidation is blocked. So in alcoholism, there is inhibition of fatty acid oxidation, and it leads to increased level of fatty acids in the liver, and then these fatty acids are accumulated in the form of triacylglycerol. So alcoholism causes fatty liver by two important mechanisms. First, by inhibiting oxidation of fatty acids, and by second, by promoting lipogenesis. The third cause of fatty liver is reduced removal of fats from the liver due to impaired lipoprotein synthesis. And the lipoprotein which carries endogenous triglyceride from liver to peripheral tissue is VLDL. And for formation of VLDL, ApoB, apoprotein is required, and phospholipids are required. After VLDL formation, the triacylglycerol are carried by this VLDL from liver to the peripheral tissue for utilization. In case of protein energy malnutrition, there is defective ApoB synthesis. In case of chemical poisoning like carbon tetrachloride, arsenic, lead, ethionine, they inhibit the protein synthesis, and due to defective ApoB synthesis, VLDL formation cannot occur. Thus, they prevent the formation of VLDL. If choline, inositol, essential fatty acids, these are the lipotropic factors, if they are deficient, then phospholipid formation cannot occur. So in all these conditions, the VLDL formation cannot be occur properly, and the triacylglycerol then cannot be removed from the liver in the circulation, and that's why they get accumulated in the liver and it leads to fatty liver. Now let's talk about lipotropic factors. These factors are required for normal mobilization of fat from liver, and dietary deficiency of these factors result in fatty liver. So these are the factors which can prevent fatty liver. There are various lipotropic factors like choline, inositol, methionine, vitamin E, selenium, vitamin B12, folic acid, and essential fatty acids. So how choline and inositol are important? Choline and inositol, they are constituents of phospholipids, because lecithin is made up of choline. It is the phosphatidylcholine, and inositol is required for formation of phosphatidyl inositol. And these phospholipids are the integral component of lipoprotein VLDL. So if there is decreased choline and inositol, it leads to decreased VLDL synthesis and triglyceride export, which leads to fatty liver. How methionine is important? Methionine is required for the formation of lecithin, that is phosphatidylcholine. The active form of methionine, that is S-adenosyl methionine, it is the methyl group donor for formation of choline, which is required for lecithin, and that's how methionine is also a lipotropic factor. Vitamin E and selenium, they are also lipotropic factor because of their antioxidant effects. Vitamin B12 and folic acid, they are involved in the formation of methionine from homocysteine, because for conversion of homocysteine to methionine, vitamin B12 and folic acid is required, and methionine is required for the formation of choline, as it is a methyl group donor, and that's how vitamin B12 and folic acid are important lipotropic factors. Essential fatty acids, if there is decreased essential fatty acid, there is decreased formation of phospholipids, because the arachidonic acid is important constituent of phosphatidylcholine, that is lecithin, and it is derived from linoleic acid, which is an essential fatty acid, and that's how if there is decreased level of essential fatty acid, it leads to fatty liver. The next topic is alcohol metabolism.